Sola Scriptura, everyone. This is His Word Only. Alright, let's get right into this. So today we're going to be going over the ability that the principalities have to transform and to transform things. But for further ado, let's get right into this. So to begin this subject, you have to talk about 2 Corinthians 11, 12 through 17. But what I do, that I will do, that I may cut off occasion from that which desire occasion. This means puff somebody up, you know, praise them and stuff like that. That wherein they glory, they may be found even as we. For such are apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. I say again, let no man think me a fool. If otherwise, yet as a fool receive me, that I may boast myself a little. That which I speak it not after the Lord, but as it were foolishly, in the confidence of boasting. So there you guys go. The full context of the whole thing. They're able to transform themselves, right? Both the good side and the bad side. Now, we're going to get into what is called the Book of Adam and Eve. Take the whole book with a grain of salt. Put it up with scripture. Take it with that, you know. Just bringing it up. And I would say, more or less than not, most of it, you know, probably isn't, but I haven't read, I've only read just a little bit of it, so not, can't say whether it is or not. I'm just going to give you the stuff that agrees with scripture, right? But anyways, chapter 6 of the book of Adam and Eve. But God looked upon them, for they had killed themselves through grief, but he would raise them and comfort them. He therefore sent his word unto them, that they should stand and be raised forthwith. And the Lord said unto Adam and Eve, you transgressed of your own free will, until you came out of the garden in which I had placed you. Of your own free will have you transgressed. Through your desire for divinity, greatness, and an exalted state, such as I have, basically to be like God, right? So that I deprived you of the bright nature in which you then were, and I made you come out of the garden to this land, rough, of full and trouble. If only you had not transgressed my commandment, and had kept my law. Huh. Interesting. And had not eaten of the fruit of the tree. They only had one, you know. But anyways, near which I told you not to come. And there were fruit trees in the garden ready for this. This is kind of crazy if this is true. And there were fruit trees in the garden better than that one. So, there are fruit trees that looked better for you and everything in that garden, according to this, right? According to this, let me preface that, okay, guys? I am no wise giving my approval of this book, you know, just interesting stuff here. Remember to hold it up to scripture. Okay. But the garden better than that one. It says, but the wicked Satan, who continued not in his first estate, that's interesting, We'll get into that here in a second. Nor kept his faith, in whom was no good intent towards me, and who thought I had though I had created him, yet set me at naught, and sought the Godhead, so that I hurled him down from heaven. He, and notice this, he's already in heaven here. But anyways, we won't get into that. He it is who made the tree appear pleasant. See? He made it appear pleasant in your eyes until you ate it by the hearkening to him. Thus have you transgressed my commandment. Therefore I brought upon thee all these sorrows. Quite interesting. Now there's another thing here. Now we're going to get into chapter 27. When Satan, the hater of all good, saw how they continued in prayer, and how God communed with them and comforted them, and how he had accepted their offering, Satan made an apparition. Okay? He began with transforming his hosts. In his hands was a flashing fire, and they were in a great light. He then placed his throne near the mouth of the cave, because he could not enter it by the reason of their prayers. And he shed light into the cave, and to the cave glistened over Adam and Eve, while his host began to sing praises. There we go. This is agreeing with the Word of God here. Quite interesting. Maybe not all of this, but that part is. Now, again, I'm not endorsing this book. Okay, just letting you guys know. Okay, and Satan did this in order that when Adam saw the light, he should think within himself that it was a heavenly light, and that Satan's hosts were angels, and that God had sent them to watch at the cave and give him light in the darkness. So that when Adam came out of the cave and saw them, and Adam and Eve bowed to Satan, that he would overcome, and thereby second time humble him before God. When therefore Adam and Eve saw the light, fancying it was real, they strengthened their hearts. Yet, as they were trembling, Adam said to Eve, "Look at that great light and those many songs of praise, and at the host standing outside that do not come into us. Do not tell us what they say, or whence they come, or what is the meaning of this light, and that, or what those prayers or praises are, wherefore they have been sent hither, and why they do not come in. If they were from God, they would come to us in the cave and would tell us their errand." There you go. There you go. Starting to get us some smarts in there, I guess, huh? Anyways, then Adam stood up and prayed unto God with fervent heart and said, "O Lord, is there in the world another God than thou, who created angels and filled them with light and sent them to keep us? Who would come with them? But lo, we see these hosts and stand at the mouth of the cave. They are in a great light. They sing loud praises. If they are somewhat from other God than thou, tell me. And if they are sent by thee, inform me of the reason which thou hast sent them." No sooner had Adam said this than an angel from God appeared unto him in the cave. See the difference? Who said unto him, "Adam, fear not. This is Satan and his host. He wishes to deceive you as he deceived you at first. For the first time, he was hidden in the serpent." Remember how I said Satan, possessed the Leviathan? Or a Leviathan, I should say. A Leviathan. I'll show you here in a second in this book here. I gotta remember where it's at real quick. But this time it has come to you in the solitude of an angel of light. Okay. In order that when you worshipped him, he might enthrall you and in the very presence of God. But anyways, it goes with all that. You guys can read it for yourself, but I'll go ahead and find that for you guys real quick. We're in chapter 17 and 18 here. I'm just going to read a little bit of both. But anyways, then Adam and Eve came to the mouth of the cave from which From which Satan came and he deceived Adam and Eve. They found the serpent that became Satan. Quite interesting. I had no knowledge of this book, guys. I was just reading the scriptures when I came to this conclusion. Plus, now you see TV, right? And here it is. I don't know what to say. You know, I'm not going to give my, you know, stamp of approval on it, you know. And I'm not the one to do that anyways, you know. But it's just quite interesting. You know, it's interesting stuff here. But anyways, here. Okay, then the word of the God, because basically the serpent is mad at them. Right, here we go. And whereas foremost the most exalted of all the beasts, now it was changed and become slippery in the midst of them all, and crept on its breast and went on its belly. And whereas it was the fairest of all beasts, it had been changed and was become the ugliest of them all. Instead of feeding on their best food, or on the best food, it turned to eat the dust. Instead of dwelling as before in the best places, now it lived in dust. Quite interesting. And whereas it had been the most beautiful of all beasts, all of which stood dumb at its beauty and now abhorred of them. Anyways. Okay. Chapter 18 here. Then the word of God came to the serpent and said unto it, in the first instance I made thee glib, and made thee go unto or upon thy belly, but I did not deprive thee of speech. I've done a video on that. Now, however, be thou dumb, and speak no more, thou and thy race. So there's more Leviathans. Quite interesting. So, anyways, I just wanted to, it's just interesting stuff there, guys. So, now let's get into the kept not their first estate. This is the same, he's talking about all the angels, right, that are with Satan and the watchers as well, right? Jude 6, and the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, he had reserved with everlasting chains and under darkness into the judgment of the great day. So that's all of them, guys. Just like Satan did. Quite interesting. So, we're going to get into Stoicheon, right? I've done a video on this. Probably a very, not the best quality. I had a cheapy mic back then. But, so the Stoicheon are the one that the Bible and Paul is talking about, right, is elemental spirits. We're going to see here. So, the usage. The heavenly bodies. A rudiment. An element, a rudimentary principle, an elementary rule. These are the ones we're going to focus on here. Heavenly bodies. Elemental spirits. However, or the RSV, however, rendered Stoicheia or Stoicheion in English as elemental spirits, spiritual powers, or cosmic spirits. This views Stoicheion elements as an ancient ancestral beings associated with the in the very beginning. Oh my goodness. Excuse me. Make up the earth. So, there you go. There's the elemental spirits. They play a big part in this as well, right? So now we're going to get into skinwalkers. Native American skinwalkers. In the American Southwest, the Navajo, Hopi, Utes, and other tribes each have their own version of a skinwalker. But each boils down to the same thing. A malevolent witch capable of transforming itself into a wolf, coyote, bear, bird, or any other animal. When the transformation is complete, the human witch inherits the speed, strength, or cunning of the animal whose shape it has taken. So, there you guys go. That's interesting. There's a little satyr there, huh? Or a minotaur type thing. Skinwalkers are purely evil in intent. I'm no expert on it, but the general view is that skinwalkers do all sorts of terrible things. They make people sick, and they commit murders. Okay. Okay, for the Navajo and the other tribes of the Southwest, the tales of skinwalkers are not mere legend. Rather, the belief is strongly held, particularly in the Navajo Nation. Anthropologist David Zimmerman of the Navajo Nation Historic Preservation Department explains skinwalkers are folks that possess knowledge of medicine, both practical, healing the sick, and spiritual, maintain harmony, and they both are wrapped together in ways that are nearly impossible to untangle. So, there you guys go. Skinwalkers. Now, we're going to get into the Druids, right? This is WoW, World of Warcraft. It is a massively multiplayer online game, and you can change in, like, to this guy, or a bear, this guy. You can change in all kinds of things. I can't remember that. I think, is this Sonaris? I think, maybe not. I forget his name. But anyways, you guys get the gist of this, right? So that's transforming, transformation. There seems to be this element in all societies, right? The ancient societies, I should say. Not so much today, you know, but it's because the church has the modern-day institutionalized church, I should say, has just been watered down, right? We're supposed to be the supernatural force, right, out there, but yet, they'll tell somebody to go see a therapist, right, when they're the ones who are supposed to be doing it. But anyways, I digress. And let me just say this, there's good people in these churches, right? I'm not hating on them. It's the doctrines, right? The doctrines. So we're going to get into 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. The whole, you know, Satan's hosts, his workers of righteousness, you know? And we got to be vigilant, you guys, all of us, including me. I am not immune from this, right? And imagine if Joseph Smith or Muhammad or any of these people that got their stuff from angels, right, that were speaking another gospel, they should have took this into account. And, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. Do they agree with God's word? Is what they're saying agreeing with his word, right? So, Hebrews 13:2. Be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. Quite interesting. Alright? And they can look like us. Who knows? The Malkiel, the messengers of heaven, right, is what their name entails. The Malkiel, right? And they may very well have been the saints of the old world, you know? I mean, who knows? I'm speculating there, you know. Can't prove it. But just interesting stuff to think about, you know? So now we have, oh yes, transmogrify. So we're going to look at transmogrifying, you know, items. Okay. Transmogrifying transitive verb to change or alter greatly and often with grotesque or humorous effect. Or we can go here, transform in a surprising or magical manner. This is what a lot of the Stoicheon did, the elemental spirits, right? That's where this stuff comes from, basically, a lot of it. Now we're going to get into Callisto. In Greek mythology, a nymph, or else a daughter of either Lycaon of Arcadia or of Nisaitis of Cetius, Callisto was one of the goddess Artemis, huntress and companions, and swore to remain unwed. But she was loved by Zeus, and in several variations of the legend, was turned into a she-bear. So let's go back to this right here, right? Where is it? Right here. Right? Remember, this is what the World of Warcraft, I think all the druids can do this. There's a bear. There you go. But anyways, okay, where was I? She bear, or by Artemis or Hera, okay, who were enraged at her unchastity. Callisto was then killed during the chase by Artemis, who, owing the machinations of the jealous Hera. Anyways, yeah, that goes in all that nonsense. And it looks like I forgot one. I'll go ahead and bring that up real quick. I know why it wasn't there, because it was supposed to be the First John 4, 1 through 4, and I was going to do 1 through 4, and spaced it. Anyway, so we're going to leave off with this. 1 John 4, 1 through 4. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because the many false prophets are gone out in the world. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye heard that it should come, and even now already is in the world. So it was already there, guys. And one thing Rob Skiba said, I know I keep bringing it up, but is, why does the whole world go after the beast and wonder after him and worship him? Because we already are. You know, like that blew my mind back then, you know? But anyways, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Amen. I'll go ahead and leave you guys with that. I hope you guys learned something from this, and maybe we can be more aware of our surroundings and what's going on, you know. And I want to give you guys some ammunition, some defense against this, right? That's what this whole channel is about. To give you guys some defense and knowledge on who the enemy is, right? And it's not with people, right? You know, here. Or now. But we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but with principalities, with spiritual wickedness in high places, right? So if you hate some other person, you're doing it wrong. Sorry to tell you. If you have ill will towards, let's say, the cabal, I guess, if you want to call it that, or whatever, you know, they appear to them, right? That's who we need to focus on, right? And the doctrines. But anyways, I hope you guys were edified, and thank you for watching, and you guys have a wonderful day.